What's up, New World Explorers, adventurers, and friends? Bigheadkitty back with another video. Today's question I'm asking is, can you still make gold in New World with all the changes, with dwindling player base, a lot of people moving to different servers, lots of bots and stuff? Short answer is yes, and the longer answer is a little more complicated, but you definitely can, and I'm going to show you some ways that you still can, so stay tuned. So right now I'm currently on Castle of Steel server. We had a pretty good group on there before, a lot of people, but it seems like that's kind of like died off a little bit. Some of the big companies, I don't know if they got bored, they took over all the territories and then they just got bored and left, I guess, or maybe they're got some gold sellers in there. I'm not sure, but so it seems with them, a lot of the bots have gone. So a lot of these prices are going to be for a Castle of Steel server. So some of the first things were just going to be basically farming items, but any of the stuff that you make the rune glass cases with, so like sulfur chunks, sandstone. Right now, sulfur chunks sell are 10 gold a piece, sandstones right around 5 gold each, and then the ectoplasm that you use is around 175 to 200 gold. So those are some pretty good ways to make some gold there. And moving along, we're going to go and we're going to talk about some other farming. Hyssop right now is around 1 gold, so that's perfect to farm. And then bananas, as usual, they're right around 3 gold again, so that's an excellent thing to farm. They seem like they sell pretty quick. And then if we want to go into some of the other things like the gathering proficiencies, star metal ore is around 0.5 to 0.6 gold each right now, and dark hide is back up to around 0.5 gold each. So those are some of the things that you can farm for some big gold. And then if you want to start crafting, there's some other things that we can do with some of those items. So with crafting, there's a few things we can do. Of course, you're going to want to still do your daily cooldown, so your prismatic ingots, your leathers, your cloths, and etc. And if you go with a strategy where you farm the most expensive items, so like the star metal or a calcum ore, maybe the silk, I think, the silk threads, and then also the dark hide. If you farm those more expensive things and then just buy the really cheap ones and make sure you wear your appropriate gear to give you the boost, like your smelter's gear, your weaver's gear, etc., you're going to get a lot of extra items, and it's a good way to make some gold as well. And then if you have 250 crafting skill and things like armoring or jewel crafting or arcana, you can make some of the special items that are used to make the armor, jewelry, and weapon matrix. So things like the honing acid are really good, sell for 1800 to 1900 gold each, and you have a 25% chance to actually get those each time. And if you're good at crafting and you get something like an Azoth Adducer or your chromatic seals with your faction points and some gold, you can make some best in slot gear and sell that as well. So those are awesome ways to make gold as well. And one other thing you can do for some pretty decent gold is just do OPR. So Outpost Rush, you just do that. Probably takes 10 minutes each time or so average, because sometimes you're going to get steamrolled. Sometimes you'll be on the team that does the steamrolling. So if you score your 3,000 points, you can usually get between 270 and I think 330 gold for each win, plus your Azoth Salt. And then each time you get a marker on your ranks, of course, you're going to get items. So I always get the gypsum orbs with that if they come up, even though they're kind of expensive, because you can use those to craft those other high dollar items. But sometimes you'll get small, large piles of coins that can be anywhere between 800 to 2,000 coins. And then sometimes you'll get like a piece of adamant or a hardened crystal or one of the major crafting items, and you can sell those for big gold. So as usual, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Appreciate it. Consider giving a like and a subscribe. Thanks.